यद्यप्येते न पश्यन्ति
यद्यप्येते न पश्यन्ति
लोभो लोभोपहत चेतसा
लोभोपहत चेतसा
कुलक्षय कृतं दोषं
कुलक्षय कृतं दोषं
मित्रद्रोहे च पातकं
मित्रद्रोहे च पातकं
कथं न ज्ञेयमस्माभिः
कथं न ज्ञेयमस्माभिः
पापादस्मान्निवर्तितुम्
कुलक्षयकृतं दोषम्
प्रपश्यद्बीर्जनार्दना Translation: O Janardana, although these men, overtaken by greed, see no fault in killing one's family or quarreling with friends, why should we, with knowledge of the sin, engage in these acts?
The other party, Duryodhana's party, they were not considering all these pious or impious, sinful or vicious activities. Because lobha upahata cetasa, they have lost their sense on account of greediness for acquiring the empire. When one becomes lusty or overpowered by greediness, then he loses all intelligence. There are many places stated there. Kamastastha hitabhyana jajanti annadevata. Krishna says that those who are worshippers of other demigods, actually worshipful is the Supreme Lord Krishna. Others, they should be shown respect. But worship means for the Supreme Personality of God. He is worshipful. Saranyam. He is to be taken shelter of, he is to be worshipped. That is being taught. That is religion. Manmanabhava adhvaktam adhyari mang namaskuru. Always thinking of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, worshipping him, offering obeisance. That is Krishna consciousness movement. The deity room, offering obeisances, worshipping, chanting, dancing, always be engaged to offer respect and submission to the Supreme Personality. This is the duty of everyone. Because all living entities are by constitution eternal servant. That is their healthy position. So long they remain servant of the Supreme, that is healthy. Same example I have given many times, that my part and parcel of the body, this finger, so long it is fit to give service to the body, it is healthy. If it cannot give service, then it is disease. Similarly, all living entities who are not giving, rendering any service to the Lord, they are simply working for sense gratification, that is diseased condition. And in the diseased condition, nobody can be happy, that is not possible. If you have got some disease, you cannot be happy. So that is the position. They cannot understand that by serving Krishna, we become healthy or in our normal position. This is called ignorance. Somebody is trying to forget him, somebody is trying to become equal with him. This business is going on. Nobody is submitting that, my Lord, I forgot my service. From this day, I become again your servant. Please give me protection. Sarvadharman parityajyamande. This is the teaching of all Shastra, all Vedas. But these people the other party, they have become blind. They have become blind. Why? Lobha apahata cetasa. They have lost their sense. Kulakkhaya kritam dosam. There is a great fault by destroying dynasty. Nowadays people are destroying from the womb. Abortion, contraception, destroying. They do not know. Kulakkhaya. Actually, putra. Putra means, pu means punnamo narakam. There is a hell which is called pun nama narak. And tra means trayate, deliver. So putra means punnamo narakat trayate iti putra. The Sanskrit word for son. Putra means that the son is expected to deliver the forefathers from the Hades condition of life. Sometimes due to our sinful activities, we become ghosts. There is very hellish condition. So when Shraddha is offered by the Putra, who will offer? The Putra will offer, that is the duty. Then he gets again material body. These are the subtle laws. People do not know. Neither they are eager to know. But these are the information we get from Vedic literature. Putra has got a duty to save the forefathers. Therefore, one has to, it is his duty to keep a putra. At least one son he must leave. But people are not very much anxious to have putra, rather to kill putra. They are so sinful. Kama lova hata chetasa. Simply sense enjoyment, that's all. Why bhaja, why one should marry? Putrarthe kriyate bharja. Bharja means wife. One accepts a wife. Why? For a putra. For a son. Oh, why son is required? Putra pindam prayajanam. Offering oblations by the putra to deliver the forefathers. That is prayajanam. That is absolutely necessary. Each and every one should leave a putra before his death. He has got so many duties. This is Vedic civilization. But nobody now cares for that. Neither it is possible. Therefore, the only remedy is to surrender. Sarannam. Devursi bhutaptu ninang pitrinam. Nayagarini na kinkara rajan, sarvatmanaji saranang sarannam gato mukundam parihyuttukattum. The one excuse is that every one of us, we are indebted to devarsi, devata, the demigods. The demigods, just like Indra, he supplies us water. Just like we are obliged to pay tax to the water department, to the fire department, to the education department, so many departments, government. Or once we pay our income tax, that is distributed to so many departments. So actually, why we pay? Because we are indebted. Now the sun sign, we are getting advantage of sun sign. So we are indebted to the sun god. Similarly, we are indebted to the moon god. We are receiving so much advantages. Burun, Deva. So we are indebted to so many demigods. Similarly, we are indebted to the rishis. Just like Vyasadeva, he has given us this Vedic literature. We are taking advantage of it. So, we must feel indebted. Devarshi, rishi. First of all, we are indebted to the devatas, and then to the rishis, then to bhuta, ordinary, living entities, just like you are taking milk from the cows. We are indebted. No, we are killing them. They are committing simply sinful life and they want to be happy and peaceful. You see? We are indebted. I am obliged to you for your service. So instead of feeling obligation, if I cut your throat, how gentleman I am. You see? Imagine. So we are indebted. Devarshi bhutapto ninang pitrina, this pitrina, kulakha, forefathers. I've got this body from my grandfather, my father has got this body, from my father I've got this body. I was indebted because this body, human body, is a chance for understanding, for my position. I can get out of the clutches of this maya of transmigrating from one body to another. So this opportunity I have got by the grace of my forefathers. These are feelings of obligation. And there is duty. Therefore, Arjuna is considering so many things because he is devotee. Kulakshaya kritanga dosanga mitraddo hi cha pakakam. These rascals, they have become lost of their intelligence on account of greediness for acquiring the empire. But so far, I am concerned, Arjuna says, katham na gyam asmabhi, plural number, by us. Us means including Krishna. He is saying, not I, or by me. He is including Krishna. You are in this side. So, because you are on my side, you are my charioteer, if I do not consider all these things, what people will say? That Arjuna is such a great devotee of Krishna, and Krishna is there, he is committing such sinful activities. Therefore, he says, kathagna gyam asmabhi. He is dragging Krishna also. That is right, yes. A saintly person, a devotee, should consider all these things before acting, whether I am doing it properly or improperly. This is Arjuna. The other party, lobha upahata cetasam, apahata cetasam. They have lost their sense, but we cannot. A devotee must be very responsible. He must act in such a way that nobody can blame him. Otherwise, everyone says, what kind of devotee he is? So, this is the duty. They should be very cautious. Sannyasi, they should be very cautious. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Sannyasi alpa chidre bahu kori mane. A ordinary grihastha or grihastha only. If he talks with a woman, nobody will blame. He is grihastha. But if a sannyasi talks with a woman very intimately, immediately, people will talk, no doubt. Sannyasi alpa chidre bahu karima. That is the practice. He should be very cautious. So a devotee, a sannyasi, they have got very, very great responsibility. People will very easily criticize them. So Arjuna is considering all these points. Kathanganakyam asmabhi papad asman nivartitam. They may indulge in these sinful activities. How we can indulge? What people will say? kulakshaya kritang dushang prapasad bhi janardana, he janardana. You are maintainer of the people. So if people become sinful, though it is very difficult to maintain them. These things have been concerned. Kulakshaya. So we cannot destroy family. But on one condition, we can become free from all these obligations. What is that? Gato saranam parihutta kattam. Saranam. Mukunda charan. One who has dedicated his life simply to serve Mukunda, Krishna. Mukunda. Muk means mukti, liberation. And Ananda. Krishna gives liberation. His name is Govinda, Mukunda. Hundreds and thousands of names Krishna has got. So, if one has taken, fully surrendering unto the lotus feet of Mukunda, he has no more any obligation. Either this Pitri, Devarishi, Deva, Devata, Demigod, Rishi, Bhuta, he is immune. Because he is transcendental. But so long one is not a devotee, one who is not fully surrendered to the lotus feet of Mukunda, he must have to follow all these regulatory principles and duties. He cannot be released. Everything account is kept. Prakriti kriyamana nigunai karmani sarvasa. Everything is noted down. Karmana daivanatrena. According to his karma, he is going to get another body. These are the subtle laws. Therefore, kulakshayam dosham. You cannot destroy your family. Materially, you cannot destroy your family. So, Arjuna is speaking. Kulakshayam kritang dosham prapasyad bhijanarda. We can see. These rascals, they have lost their intelligence. But when we see how we can destroy the family, the further explanation is given. Next.
Translation. With the destruction of dynasty, the eternal family tradition is vanquished, and thus the rest of the family becomes involved in irreligious practice.
So much responsibility is there, killing the family. Because they have no responsibility at the present moment, everyone irreligious. Two things are there, religion and irreligion. Krishna also says, jada jada hi dharmasya glani bhavati abhuthanam adharmas. If we cannot keep on religious principles, then we have to do something, then we have to enhance our irreligious principles. So this family tradition, according to Vedic civilization, was very strictly observed. So that the family may be kept in order in religious principle. Why? Now because the human life is meant for reviving his eternal position, sanatam, which word is used here. Kuladharma sanatana. The real purpose of life, especially human life, is meant for reviving our sanatana dharma, sanatana occupation, eternal occupation. By observing the rules and regulations of varnasrama dharma, four varnas and four asrama, that is called kula dharma. Brahmana, kshatriya, vaishya, shudra, brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, and sannyasi. each one of them must strictly observe the rules and regulations of that particular ashram. Why it should be observed so strictly? Because by observing the regulative principle of each stages of life, one will be able to please the Supreme Personality of God. Parnasamacharvata purushena parapumar Vishnu aradhate nanna tattu sukaranam. If we observe strictly the rules and regulations of Kuladharma, Kuladharma means if you are a Brahmana, you must observe the regulative principles, the qualitative principles of a Brahman. If you are in a Kshatriya, then you must also observe the Kshatriya principle. All these are described in the Bhagavad Gita. Who is Brahmana, who is Kshatriya, by symptoms. By symptoms we have to accept whether one is Brahman or Kshatriya or Vaishya, not by birth. That is the injunction of the Shastra. So this has to be observed if we want actually deliverance from this material entanglement. So these rules and regulations of Kuladharma we must observe. If we do not observe, then immediately we become irreligious. Dharme nasti kritam kristam adharma abhibhavati iti uta. Uta, Arjun said, it is said, he has learned from higher authorities. Uta, it is said means said by authorities. So, if adharma, irreligious life, is propagated on account of loss of Kuladharma, then everything is lost, Raja Krishna. So, why shall I kill? Other things also will be described later on, that when the male members are killed, the female members become widow, and their character becomes polluted. So many things Krishna will speak about this family life. So at the present moment there is no such family life, no consideration of religion, no consideration of irreligious life, everything just like animals. Kalau Shudra Sambhava. If not animals, they are all Shudras. Nobody Brahmana, nobody Kshatriya, nobody Vaishya. So it is a chaotic condition of the human society. Therefore, it cannot be revived to the original position of systematic, institutional position. It is not possible. Everything is lost. Therefore, by the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's grace, one thing, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Iva Kevalam, Kalo Unasti, Unasti, Iva Gatirannatha. Everything is lost. Now, simply by chanting Hare Nama, the holy name of Lord Krishna, you become again situated in the original position. Everything is adjusted because it is transcendental. So there is no other way. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is so merciful that from the Shastras he has selected this process of Sankirtan movement, Chaita Darpana Marjanam Bhava Mahadavagni Nirbhav. The human life is meant for extinguishing the blazing fire of material existence. But we are not in regulative principles. We have lost everything, our Sanatana Kula Dharma, everything. Under these circumstances, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives us the greatest facility according to Shastra. That is the boon of this age. Kirtanadeva Krishna Samukta Sangha Paramba. Simply by chanting the holy name of Krishna, everyone becomes free from all contamination of this age. Mukta Sangha Parang Braja. And he becomes so purified that he becomes fit to go back to home, back to Godhead. This opportunity, chanting of Hare Krishna mantra, we should not miss. Where is the difficulty? Hare Krishna, chanting, Kirtaniya Sada Hari, Tinadapi Sunichena, Tarurapi Sahishnana. This is the only savior for the human society of this age. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.